Okay, yesterday we have started one sleeve. Create file that we have to open the requested file and return the content of that file to the client. Means on console we have to show the content. If anything goes wrong, throw a error 404. This error we have to throw. So in this error part, we have to throw this error. If something goes wrong, for example, particular file is not exist, that time it will throw error. So what kind of error that? Error 404 400, and we can mention that file does not exist. So yesterday we have done all other part, only this line is remaining. Throw 400, file does not exist. You have completed write mode file. Open that file and you can add that one line only. This is comment, no need to write it. Open yesterday's file, write mode file. In that file, just add one line, throw, and error name, error 400. So this file we have created yesterday, open file write mode. So in this file here, we have written console.log and error we have printed there. So instead of that, we will use throw, and this is a text. In this text, we are passing that error 400 means file does not exist. While execution, if your file name is college, complete name, remove one character. So means that file is not exist on your drive. That time we have to get this error. We have to show this error. If error is not there, we have to show the content. Execute the file. Here. We have thrown the error. Error 400, file does not exist. This is our output. And if there is no error, means file is exist, it has to show the content of your file. So these are the content of my file. So you have to execute this file both way. First, we have to show the error also, and second way, we have to show the content also. Both are output of this file. Complete this. This is a sleep program. You are doing right?
Yes, ma'am.
Only afterward change the name of the file, because we are not opening this file in write mode. Syntax was same, that's why I have written code in this file only, because we have changed the mode of file. This is R means read mode. We have changed the mode of file in read mode. That's why this name is not matching with this code. Previously there were W for writing file. Let me know after completion. See, only one line you have to write. Yesterday we have written all these five. Complete or not? Yes.
Done.
So you have to show this file two way. One part will show the content of file, and second part will show the error part. So that is in your sleep only. Create Node.js file that opens requested file and returns the content to the client. So if that file is exist, it will show the output as a your file output, file contents. And if anything goes wrong, throw 404 error. So this is one sleep. Shall we move ahead, everyone?
Ma'am, just one second.
Done. Yes. Who said 1 second?
Sameer, बोलो.
हाँ मैम, लेट आया था ना, इसलिए एक मिनट. हाँ.
कल का ही प्रोग्राम है, ऐसे एक लाइन ऐड करनी थी उसमें। कल हमने वो पूरी स्लिप किए है, सिर्फ ये लाइन की वजह से रुकाया था मैं।
ओके मैम, हो गया अभी।
अभी नेक्स्ट प्रोग्राम है इसके ऊपर ही। रीड द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट। क्रिएट Node.js एप्लीकेशन टू सर्च ए पर्टिकुलर वर्ड इन ए फाइल एंड रिप्लेस ऑल ऑकरेंस ऑफ दैट वर्ड विद द अनदर वर्ड एंड बोल्ड ऑल। सो दिस थिंग वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू सर्च पर्टिकुलर वर्ड इन फाइल एंड वॉट एवर मैचिंग वर्ड्स आर देयर ऑल वर्ड्स वी हैव टू रिप्लेस एंड आफ्टर दैट वी हैव टू मेक द सेंटेंस इन बोल्ड फॉर्मेट। So this format is not visible in this console, but it will show B tag. So that B tag will decide, that means because of this, if you use this sentence in HTML, automatically these things will be in bold format. So here, first line is we have to import FS module. Do with me. First line, import FS module. Then open file using a read file method fs dot read file. First parameter is your path, file path. Then encoding part, and third one is callback. So while reading, if there is any error, so it will show that error here, return console.log error. Otherwise, it will go to execute our logic. That is, in this data part, we will get the content of file. If there is no error, so whatever content of this college.txt, that will be stored into this data. So here we are applying a replace function on this data. Data dot replace. What we have to replace? We can write this thing in the single quote also, like this. We have to replace Pune. Means this word should be in our file. We have to write such a word that we have to replace. So we will write this. We will replace Pune with Pune. We will change the Pune word with Pune. Wherever there is a Pune in your file, that will be replaced by this word Pune. So after performing this operation, we have to write that content in the file. We have to update our file also. So this result part we are writing here in the file. fs.write file. This is path of file. What content we have to write, that is here. Then encoding part. And this is the callback function. If error occur, it will return that error on console. Otherwise, it will end your program. Now you can go to your text file and watch the changes. If immediately, if you want to see that changes, you can check that changes here also. Sometimes immediately it is not showing that result on console, but it has a reflection in your text file. So we can use another program. Already we have a read function, a read file program. If you execute that program immediately, you will get the output. After some time, this console is going to show the output. If it is not showing, you can show the text file to examiner, or we can execute another read file function. We have various functions. We can execute that function with the same file. There you can get the output whatever we want. Complete this. To convert the data part in bold format, this is the logic. In this data, here we have read that data. All the file contents are stored into this data part. On this data, we are applying bold function. Done.
Yes, ma'am.
Now see the execution. First, in this college.txt, you will check your file. You have to write this Pune word. So when you will execute that function, that time it will change this from Pune to Pune. What is that file name? A replace. Yes, this is the file. So node replace word in file one dot txt, sorry, dot js. So here immediately it is not showing output, but we have other file also, that read file asynchronously or a read file synchronously. We can call that file because same file I have written there also, that is college.txt. So here, from here we can get the output. First, see output here. Here you can see that word is replaced. Written txt. Yes. You can call other file to show the output. Here, that file word is replaced with this Pune. In that file, you can check here, B tag is mentioned here. That means all the sentence are in bold format. Done. So this is the question: search a particular word in a file and replace all occurrences of that word. So wherever Pune is there, they have changed that word into Pune. Done. Now I am getting that output. After some time, they are showing the output, Pune, using the same file, replace word in file one. Yes, completed. Now next sleep is create Node.js application to count number of lines in a file and display the count on console. So how many lines are there in your text file, that will be a count of your file and that we have to show on console. So here your file, how many lines are there, we will check first. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So 7 will be your output. Here in the output it is shown 7. So you can write count of the total number of lines of particular file is 7. You can show that output also. So for that reason we have to write this code. So what is that code? First import fs module. Write down import fs module. Then second line is read file synchronously. We have to open this file means to read the content of that file. That file data is going to store into this file buffer variable. After that we will apply or we will take one variable to stream, means this contents are in binary form, buffer data is there, this content are in binary form, we have to convert that content into string. So we will apply to string function on the output of above line, that is file buffer. So this is binary data 0001, in that format we will get that data. Now we have to convert that data into string, so we will apply file buffer dot to string function, and that result means total content of your file will be stored into this to string. Now we have to check the number of lines. For that this method, this function is written, split function. We have to split the lines whenever there is a slash n, means whenever your line will be end, means there is a slash n. So we have to search the count of your line by using this only. How many slash, on the basis of that you will get the number of lines of your file, and that is going to store into this split underscore lines. Here we are splitting this using slash n, and we are calculating the length of that split lines string by using length function. So this function will give the count of lines. So go to console, check your file name first. Number of lines in file. Node. Number of lines in file dot js. Number of lines 7. You can increase or decrease the line from this. Then execute this. Number of lines 6. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
सबका हो गया।
यस मैम।
Now go to the next program. Write Node.js application that shows some information when your Node.js application gets started. Means when your application gets started, that time we can use some information such as I have given here, welcome to the Node.js application. So this is the starting part. Then warning when it tries to open an existing file. If file is already existed, then we can show that warning file already exists. Add error message while that specified file is not found. If that file is not found, then we have to show the error message file does not exist. So here first I have imported fs, that is file system. Then this is our initial sentence. Whenever you will your application will start, this message will go to the user, welcome to the Node.js application. So initially only I have given this message using console.log. Then I have opened this file college.txt in read only mode, and function is the callback function. If error is there, we have to mention this error part, because in the question only they shown that error message while that specified file is not found. That time we will remove one character from this file name, that time it will show this message console.log file does not exist. Or else part mein kya karna hai, warning when it tries to open an existing file. To check the existing file, we have to use this exist sync method, fs dot exist sync method. In the bracket we have to pass the file path. It will check whether the file name is exist at that particular location or not. Yes, then it will give warning file name is already exist, and after that you can show the content also of that file. It is not necessary, but I have shown it here. You just have to show warning part and this error part, and first one is welcome message. So try this. Import fs file, fs module, then first line welcome message, console.log, welcome to Node.js application. Then open your file. File name, mode, and callback function. This is the second part of our question. We have to show error if file does not exist. So if error, then console.log file does not exist. Else, in else part we have to show the file exist. So they told that in question we have to give warning when it tries to open an existing file. So we have already opened that file. That file is already exist. So here we are giving message that file already exist. So remember this. If you want to check file is already exist or not, exist sync method we have to use with the file path.
मैम ये UTF-8 ये रिक्वायर्ड है क्या? मींस
इनकोडिंग फॉर्मेट है वो, इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर्मेट में ही है, इसके पैरामीटर्स है फंक्शन के. अगर आपने नहीं दिया तो बाय डिफॉल्ट जो फॉर्मेट है वो ले लेता है. बाय डिफॉल्ट में एक में UTF-8 है, एक में ASCII है, कहीं कहीं पे नल है, कुछ ब्लैंक दिखाएगा. डन.
बस
नेक्स्ट प्रोग्राम इज क्रिएट नोड जेएस एप्लीकेशन टू सर्च पर्टिकुलर वर्ड इन ए फाइल एंड डिस्प्ले द रिजल्ट ऑन console whether that word is available or not. That type of result we can show on the console. So first here you can check the output. Here in this file I have mentioned this Pune. Initially there were Pune, after that I want to check that particular word is not exist, that time I change it to Pune 1. So we have to keep Pune inside this file. We want to check the particular word, and we will write it here. So first we are giving positive part, that is word is exist. After that we will check with the another word that is already not exist in the file. So we will get here two type of error. So first Pune was there, that time I got this error. I got this output. Word is found. This is the output I have shown here. And after that, I will show the whole file content also. So you will come to know about this word. You can write their word also, which word we are going to found. For example, we will write there Pune word is found. And after that, in this file, you will get here Pune. Second, I will change the word that is not exist in the file, and I will check the output. Word is not found, and I will show the file also, file content also. So you will come to know that your search word is different and that is not available in your file. So for that reason, first write down now. First is import fs module. If you you have already one sleep regarding this searching particular word, you can save as it, you can do save as it and make some changes into that file. Other part is same. First import fs module, then read file college.txt. This is path of file, read it, comma, callback function. In this, two parameters are passed, error and data. If there is an error while execution of this file, while reading this file, it will show error. Otherwise, it will show the content of file in the data. It will store the content of file in this डेटा पैरामीटर. सो इफ एरर वी कैन थ्रो द एरर, अदरवाइज चेक द कंडीशन. इफ डेटा दिस वर्ड और दिस स्ट्रिंग कंटेन्स ऑल कंटेंट ऑफ दिस कॉलेज डॉट टी एक्स टी फाइल, सो दिस डेटा इंक्लूड्स वॉट वी आर सर्चिंग पुणे वर्ड. We are searching Pune word into this file college.txt. That data is stored into this data variable or string. So here we are searching given word. If this word is available inside this data, then we can say that word is found, and after that console.log fs.readfilesync. If you want to make it interactive, then that is also possible. We have completed one sleep of prompt sync. So using that module, we can get input from user. So instead of giving this static input, we can take input from user, and that input we can pass here. So at runtime, we are taking input from user, and we will search the particular word. So here, after checking this word, I am showing the file contents also. This is if part and else part. This particular word is not found in the data, so we will write console.log word is not found, and again if you want to show the content, then we can read the file in console using console.log method.